Hello and welcome to the Commodore 64 version of Hunchback from Ocean Software. Possibly one of the first games from Ocean. You play our little friend, and I'm not going to risk using the name because it might be copyrighted left, right, and center, but you know who it is. And he's going to traverse some screens in order to save his beloved, and I start by screwing up badly. The time limit, as you can imagine, is the knight climbing up on the left side. And if he reaches the top, he will chase you, so you better make sure he doesn't. It is single screen challenges, and some of them are, while they seem simple, might be quite nasty. It starts out easy, as you can see, but everything is pixel perfect. It's like quite tight because he will jump exactly the same distance every single time, and you have to be pixel perfect on the jumps. You can't be one tiny little pixel off. So now we have to time the jumps because we don't want to jump up into the thing at the top. So we got a special bonus for clearing 5 screens in a row. Hooray! This one you have to know about. You just. It's a bit evil. First time you get to that screen, you just. But we managed to get past it. And here is the first example of pixel position. Whee! Nope! I jumped straight up instead of jumping right, which was a bit stupid, and we screw up again because, yeah. Pixel precision, as I said. Got it right! Hi. Oops, didn't get that one right. It's all about patience more than anything else, this game. Don't rush it. Have to admit, for what it is, the age of the game and all sorts of things, it's actually quite enjoyable. I might sit myself down and actually complete this game one time. Ouch! So, the proper name to put on the high school list, of course, is EWL, EVL even, short of evil, because that's what this game is. Enjoyable, but quite challenging. So, because of the length of this video, I decided to just transition straight into Hunchback 2. Can't have too much of a good thing, can you? Hooray! Hunchback 2. This starts out with a funky little tune, which is setting me up for a massive disappointment because I think Hunchback 2 has to be considered to be one of the first cases of sequel sickness, whatever you'd call it. Whereas, the sequel just cannot compare to the original. Mean, based on the first game, who the heck came up with the idea that this would be a brilliant idea for a game. It's got no resemblance to the first game, in any way, shape, or form, except for the fact that it contains bells. Hooray! I'm spending some time trying to work out how I'm supposed to do this level, so bear with me. And those birds, things, whatever they are, they. Yeah, it's just about getting the timing right. Once you work it out, it's not too complicated, but considering the enjoyment I had with the first game, I knew I was set up for disappointment. Because this game is just not up to par. And if people been playing the first game and enjoying the first game, there's a good chance they would have forked out and bought Huntsback 2 Blind, which is, I mean, there's bound to be someone out there who likes this game, because, I mean, some people like all sorts of games, I suppose, so I shouldn't be the one to knock people's taste. But for me, this game is just not very enjoyable. It is. Frustrating without being enjoyable. Frustrating without being fun, I should say. And again, a case of when you reach game over status, you have to get back to the levels that you were struggling on, and in order to get back to those levels, you have to go through levels that you find extremely boring. So, I would definitely consider this to be what I will call sequel sickness. The second game in the series just could not live up to the quality of the first game, because the first game was simple, definitely had one more time appeal to it. In my opinion, this one doesn't, and I will reflect that on the high score table, my honest opinion about this version. I should add that Ocean released Huntsback at the Olympics, which is actually quite enjoyable, but it might be a risk to my joystick to go through it, so maybe some other time. But as for now, thanks for watching, take care, and see you again. Bye bye.